numerical on equilibrium of general force system. Determine the forces in each cable and reaction at roller D. In this figure, in cable BE, the tension force is TB. In cable CF, tension force is TC. Alpha is the angle made by cable BE with the horizontal. Beta is the angle made by CF with the horizontal. To find out these values of alpha and beta, we'll take help of this dimension. So to find out value of alpha, alpha is equal to tan inverse opposite side AT upon adjacent side 100 plus 100 200. So value of alpha comes to be tan inverse 80 upon 200, which is equal to 21.8 degree. To find out value of beta, we'll take tan inverse 80 upon 100, which value comes to be 38.66 degree. At D, there is a roller support. So reaction exerted by the surface will be perpendicular to the surface. So RD is perpendicular to the surface and it is assumed to be acting towards left. Our aim is to find out what is the value of tension force in cable BE, that is TB, and tension force TC in the cable CF. We'll apply conditions of equilibrium. So first condition of equilibrium, summation Fx equals to 0. Addition of all forces in x direction is taken equal to 0. Our assumption, forces towards right should be taken positive, forces towards left should be taken negative. So here these are the inclined forces, so we'll resolve its horizontal component, vertical component. So TB cos alpha, so TB cos alpha, value of alpha is 21.8, it is acting towards right, so plus. Then TC cos alpha, TC cos beta, value of beta is 38.66, again it is acting towards right, so plus. And minus RD is acting towards left is equal to 0. We'll simplify it, it becomes 0.928 TB plus 0.78 TC equal to RD. RD go towards right. This is equation 1. We'll apply second condition of equilibrium. Summation Fy equal to 0. Forces going upward taken positive, forces going downward taken negative. We'll take all y components. So 600, it is going downward, so minus 600. TB sine alpha, it is going up, so plus. TB sine alpha is sine 21.8. Then TC sine beta, it is going downward, so minus. And beta is nothing but sine 38.66 equal to 0. This equation is simplified as this 600 is going towards right and the sine 21.8, it is written as 0.37 TB minus 0.62 TC equal to 600 goes towards right, so becomes positive. Equation 2. Now we'll apply third condition of equilibrium, summation movement of all forces. Suppose about point B is taken equal to 0. Here is a point B and our assumption is clockwise movements positive, anti-clockwise movements negative. So we are going to take moment of 600, it is going to create anti-clockwise movement, so minus 600 at a distance of 100 mm. Then this TC, we have to take its sine component, that is TC sine beta. Beta is nothing but 38.66. These are only these two forces will be there, of which we can take the moment. Its sine cos component, its line of action is passing through B. Then RD, its line of action is passing through B, so we cannot take the moment of the sine cos component of TC and RD. So here there are only these two movements which we are taking in the equation. So here the sine component is at a distance of 100 from B. It is going to create clockwise, so it is taken plus, it is equal to 0. So here there is only one unknown TC. On simplification we get value of TC which is equal to 960.46 Newton. Now from equation 2 we will get value of TB. So from equation 2, 0.37 TB minus 0.62 TC equal to 600. So if we put value of TC which we calculated here, we will get value of TB equals to 3231 Newton. From equation 1, we will put value of TB and TC to get value of reaction RD, 0.928 TB plus 0.78 TC equal to RD. We will put value of TC and TB to get value of RD which comes equal to B, 3747.57 Newton.